Chapter 2, A New Home. Harry's Mindscape. Harry found himself standing on a grassy plain, surprisingly not injured. Behind him was a dense forest. In front of him there was a massive castle like something out of a storybook. This peaceful scene was disrupted by the arrival of something. Ah, there. It was a mass of shadows, which soon resolved into the figure of a pale-skinned man with red eyes and no nose. From the folds of this thing's robes, it pulled out a wooden stick and pointed it at him. Avada Kedavra, said the noseless thing. Harry watched as a jet of green light that shot from the stick. It streaked towards him, but then dissipated into nothing. However, hearing these words stirred something within him. Harry felt a strange energy coursing through him, and watched as the noseless thing seemed to shrink in size. Harry then realized it wasn't the noseless thing that was shrinking. No, as Harry looked around at the forest and castle, he realized he was growing. This continued until the noseless thing looked like nothing but an insect next to his massive claw. Wait. Since when did he have claws? Harry reached down and picked up the noseless thing by the back of his robes, holding it before his face. Something about this thing enraged Harry, and he felt an energy building up in his chest. He swung his forepaw upwards, tossing the noseless thing into the skies. He focused and unleashed his pent-up energy. From his maw, a stream of energies blasted forth, a beam of high-energy radiation. Needless to say, the noseless thing never came back down. The creature that Harry Potter had become raised its head to the sky and roared in victory. Monster Island. The Kyu, once known as Harry Potter, awoke from its slumber, and immediately started wondering where he was. He saw the palm trees, the waves lapping against the shores. He heard the cries of gulls and other seabirds. He felt the sand beneath him, brushing against his scales. Wait, what? Harry got to his feet, noticing his bulk as he did so. He was huge. He headed over to a tide pool, and looked into the waters, seeing his reflection. What Harry saw staring back at him was a scaly, metallic blue creature which he could only describe as a dragon. He'd read about them in books which Dudley had tossed aside because he couldn't read words with more than one syllable without significant difficulty. Only two features which showed little change: his eyes, which, despite their slit pupils, were still the emerald green as ever, and his scar. The scar which still marked his head was now outlined by a pattern in his scales. Harry wasn't really fearful or worried about his new form. In fact, he kind of liked it. Still wondering how this was possible, Harry decided to take a better look around, and saw that the beach he was on was bordered by a riggerline which separated it from the rest of this island. Harry moved over to it, and tried raising his massive body up onto its hind legs. He found he could do this without much difficulty, assuming he used his tail for balance. With this, he was able to look over the ridge easily. On the other side, he saw a fairly flat area, with a waterfall and lake on one side, and what appeared to be a volcanic vent on the other. Well, I see you've finally woken up, said a voice. Harry spun around, and saw a bipedal reptilian creature, a double line of spikes on its back which glowed faintly blue, and easily twice his size standing there. It looked like it could easily destroy him, but something within Harry's mind told him he could trust this one. W, who are you? Asked Harry, slightly intimidated. I am Godzilla, the king of monsters and all that, he said casually, and this is Monster Island, my current home. I'm sorry for trespassing, sir, said Harry, I'll be going now. Hold it right there, young one, said Godzilla, I never said you had to leave. In fact, it would be safer if you stayed here for now. Why is that? Asked Harry. Because you are a newly forged Kyu, and a child as well, said Godzilla. Those who claim themselves masters of this world, the humans, view us as nothing more than mindless beasts for the most part. They'd attack you on sight, and try either to kill or capture you. But I used to be a human, said Harry. Really? Well, you obviously aren't anymore, said Godzilla with a smile. However, While I have no objections to your presence here, you still need to pass inspection by Mothra. Who? Asked Harry. A protector of this world, who exists for that specific purpose, said Godzilla. You see, most of us are prehistoric creatures which survived into the modern day, only to get mutated into our current selves. Mothra's different. She's helped stop the world's destruction since before recorded history. Follow me. Harry followed behind his new companion, who led him to a cavern entrance on the back of the island. Once there, Godzilla gestured for him to go inside. Harry did just that, and soon the gloom of the cave surrounded him. He felt like he was being watched, and called out. Hello? Is anyone there? Asked Harry. Who is this that comes before me? Said a voice. Ah. The new arrival, seeking to become part of our family. You are quite the intriguing one, Harry James Potter. Harry took a cautious step back as this voice spoke his full name. He'd not told it to any here. Yes, said Harry, I don't know how I got here, or like this. There was the sound of wings pushing the air aside, and Harry watched as some sort of enormous butterfly, moth landed on the outcrop ahead of him. Your power is great, and your continued existence, greater still, said Mothra. One does not simply walk away from the words of death. Your pain caused by those cruel humans released a power from deep within you, which converted into the energy which fueled your transformation. What happens now? Asked Harry. That is up to you, said Mothra. I see no issues with you living here on the island, learning how to wield the new abilities you've been granted and becoming part of our family. Such training on your part would benefit the world as a whole. Of course, no one is forcing you to stay here. You are free to leave if you so wish, to try and make your own way in the world. So, what do you say? Harry considered briefly. With his new form, he truly didn't have any place he could knowingly go. As such, it wasn't a hard decision at all. I'll do it, said Harry. I want to live on the island. Excellent news, said Mothra. You are free to go. I'd suggest coming up with a new name for yourself. Harry Potter is not a name which will inspire awe and fear. The most. Harry bowed his head in thanks to Mothra, and left the cave. Outside, Godzilla was waiting for him. Ah, I see the old bug accepted you, said Godzilla. If she hadn't, she'd have driven you into the sea by now. Anyway, let's go introduce you to the others. With that, Godzilla and Harry headed off, not knowing that half a world away, the disappearance of a certain young wizard had been noticed.
Hey guys, what's going on? Thank you so much for watching today's episode. If you guys want to watch more like it, please subscribe to my channel and become part of the video game fanfiction plot. And please leave a comment down below and hit that like button. If you guys have any suggestions on any stories you guys want me to read, don't hesitate. They're always welcome here in the video game fanfic plot. That also goes for video games. Until next time, goodbye!